You see, the problem with us in this part of the world is how to continue to maintain infrastructure or whatever that it is that we build. But, you know, when you have a businessman at the ends of affair of a state, I'm referring to our governor, His Excellency Governor Dapo Abiodun. He is a businessman, come politician. You understand? He knows the essence of management of asset. So I believe with the governor and the deputy and the MDDS or the Millennium Development Goal, I believe this project will not collapse, because we from the Olota Palace, we have already key into this project, you know, very, very much. And we will ensure that the project is well maintained. And in terms of, you know, the youths or the product of that project, yeah, with the likes of KPSC involved with this now, we already have people coming to discuss with us a lot of different kind of, you know, innovations and innovatives that we will put in place, that talents will be harnessed, and from there we can expose them to international experience and everything, and we will continue to monitor them. We will continue to support them, and by the grace of Almighty God, you will see that very soon we will start having other people. You know, when I say other people, not necessarily the indigenous other alone. People, we have people living with us. We have all sorts of people with different kind of talents. I'm sure you will start seeing people coming from our other and achieving greatness by the grace of God. KPSC is, you know, has left the direction or the law for, you know, running the affairs of the town to Baba Onilogbo. KPSC, His Royal Highness, KPSC, Olufemi, His Royal Majesty, KPSC, Femi, Olufemi, Ojubele, the Onilogbo of Ilogbo. I am just part of the Olota Council that I'm just like running around for both KPSC and Baba Onilogbo. So the affairs of the town is not left for me. We have a lot of hierarchies in this Awori land that will not make me being the Seriki Opota, I won't be able to lead or be responsible for the town. But saying that, I happen to be one of the high chiefs that has been like the runner of whatever between Baba Onilogbo and KPSC. So I'm only just assisting Baba Onilogbo, who has always been very, very active. You can see that he has represented KPSC in a lot of function, and he continued to give us direction on what to do in the absence of KPSC. But I don't even think we can feel the absence of KPSC, because KPSC is on the phone 24/7 every day, monitoring everything that is going on in the town. The governor is aware that KPSC is not around, and the whole government is aware that KPSC is not around. But I don't think there is any lapse. But saying that, how it has been, well, it has been a very good experience for me. Well, you know, trying to assist Baba Onilogbo. KPSC is doing all it could to be here as soon as possible. You can understand that both the international airport are still locked, and there is no any other way for KPSC to come in legitimately into the country till the airports are open. But I can assure you that very, very soon, Kabisi will be here and then we will all rejoice. Nobody. My head is going to be on my body forever. Anyway, let me quickly talk about that interview. Well, if we have a situation whereby people fear the government, I think that is called tyranny. But if you have a situation whereby the government listens to the people, that is called liberty. I want to say that I happen to be at one at two of His Excellency's speech. One was in London, you know, before the commencement, after the election, and it was during a Thanksgiving in England. I was moved by what the governor said during that speech. But a keynote I picked from that interview was when he said, the government is going to lead, will be a responsive government. You know, it's a we have to appreciate that our governor is a businessman. And he knows the meaning of people bringing issues, saying what they need, he looking at it, and responding to people's need. That is government. If we have a situation whereby people believe nobody should speak, I don't think that's the kind of government that our governor said he want to lead. The interview I did, the transcript and the recording is there for everybody to see. We are talking objectively about the situation of our roads. Otta happened to be the industrial hub of this state. Otta happened to be the area that Ogun State generates a lot of revenues from.
The economic nerve center of the state.
Well, people say Otta is the economic nerves of the state. Now, if we are the economic nerves of this state, we are not that because of our egungun or because of our we are what they call us because of our industries and the amount of money the government generates from here. Now, if that is the case, what we are discussing during my interview was the neglect of the infrastructure that enables this revenue and allows the government to be able to call Otta what they call us, the industrial nerves of the state. Before that interview, we have a situation whereby nearly all the industries have almost downed their tools because of the road. They cannot function, they cannot take their goods out of their industries, they cannot access the Lagos market, they cannot get to the airport. The road was that bad to an extent that people use it like 3-4 hours to even get to the Lagos Abeokuta Expressway. And our interview was pointing to that roads, all those roads, be it federal road, be it state roads, be it local road. We know we have a governor that is very responsive. And you can see, after the interview, after we point these things out, now, all those roads are being attended to. Even serious palliative is going on all over those roads now. Now I ask people, do they now feel the governor will look at that kind of interview in a political view and feel, oh, he's talking, the governor is a businessman and the deputy is she's an engineer. They've risen above all these petty political clamorations that people attach to things. I heard about some people saying all those roads are not state road, this. state road or federal roads, it affects the people and the manufacturers in Nota. We want the governor to come and help us intervene. That's what we said. And the government.
I'm sorry, I want to cut you in. That stakeholder in question.
I'm not referring to any
statement. I understand. The person says, okay, one of the other statements in the committee that said some road belong to the state, some belong to the federal. Maybe he was trying to, see things from a very reasonable point of view. In my own view, that maybe some roads actually belong to the federal, which is right, some belonging to the state, that we should not be robbing Peter to pay Paul. Do you see things, you know, like he saw it, or do you see it differently? Just like you were trying to explain.
I would want to tell you that, coming from my own point of view and from what we, the traditional leaders, represent, we represent the indigenes and the residents and the manufacturers of Ota. If it is the federal road that is killing their business, we want it to be fixed. If it's the state road that is killing their business, we want it to be fixed. But we know we have a responsive governor that has listened to our cry and he... See, let me tell you something. Let me just give you a scenario. We are so lucky in Ota that this governor listens and responds to our cry. Ota has been so marginalized over the years. One of the first project that this governor did was the Ikola AIT Navy Road and in Ota. You understand? We've never had a deputy governor from this town before. He gave us the head of service. He gave us. Now, if we have a governor that is responding and trying to correct all these years of neglect, are we supposed to be quiet or tell him that all these infrastructures, all these things have been neglected over 15, 20 years, and tell him, you know, Excellency sir, please send people to come and look at these things for us? That is what he has done. Look at that Ikola Road. He promised us and he delivered. Immediately he came there, we've never had head of service before, he gave us. All the marginalization of our area, he started looking into it. Now, will I sit here as the Seriki of this town and start saying, Governor, please, Songo Road is international road, don't come and look at it for us, or Diroko Express Road is... He will use his influence to... Because all these roads are being assessed by Awori's, Ogun State people, and he will get the kudos. He's not a... See, that is why I keep telling people that try whenever they ask you to do something, put the right place or the right person at the right place. We have a businessman. You know, look, during his inauguration, Mr. Fola Adeola was there. And he said something. He said he has pointedly said he will never participate in any government in Ogun State again, because first governor that called him to come, that governor failed him. The second one failed him, and he said, no, I'm not doing anymore. But because he now sees Governor Dapo Abiodun, and he knows he can do it, he knows he's a man of his word, that was the reason he came and moderated the inauguration, which we all attended to. And he attests to the kind of character that this present governor has got. Now, hi, the Seriki of Ota, I will never think the governor will play politics with us in Ota, which he has never done since his coming. I have a very good relationship with the government, and you know, to now talk about what you said about, you know, Seriki is doing this and that because he is interested in some political this thing. Let me tell you something. They cannot. Kimfe or Je, Lemom, Kotumadu Seriki. I am the Seriki of Ota. I don't have any political interest. I don't have any political or government thing I'm looking at. I am purely for my people in Qatar. I came here because history have it that my grandfather, Seriki Alao Shitu Bashonu, was one of the prominent leaders of this town during his regime. A lot of history, you can check it. And I will continue to represent my family well, and no amount of bad mountain, you know, pressure will stop me from assisting my people.